Here are more from Goodwife Carver.
There. It's not a woman's work you do, Mr. Alden.
Beg your pardon?
Washing linens, preparing broth.
Aye.
Woman's work.
Well, I aim to help where I may, Miss Mullins.
Surely an able-bodied man as yourself would be better suited thatching a roof or the like.
If it comes to it that a roof needs thatching, I'll be there.
A gust of wind cleared a space in our roof last night.
Oh?
I shall see to it.
What is it?
Nothing, Captain.
I wasn't speaking to you. Speak up, Alden.
Taking water from the seams, Captain, from where we hit the rock earlier.
Can you fix it?
Possibly. We're made of fresh lumber.
Our splint will help us. We can fix it when we return.
Well, that's assuming we make it.
Head for the shore. We'll have a look there. Come, move! Move!
Suspect we might be good for another few hours.
Very well, then. We turn back.
No. We have a mission. We must go south.
Not in this boat, we won't.
Then we mend it. There are good trees here.
Captain, it'll take us longer to fell a tree and prepare the lumber than to double back.
I will help. Hobamok will help.
That's ours.
We are besieged.
Push!
Push!
We are local.
Push, man! Push!
Where are they taking it? I'll interrogate us one by one. Make sure our stories jibe.
And then what?
For those that survive the first purge, it'll be hard labor.
Though not like any you've ever known. But of the kind they've known. Cruel and violent. Whatever methods they've seen done to their own kind, they feel resolved to repeat it upon those they deem complicit.
Who are you?
My name is Ben Gunn. I'm the last of 13 crewmen on a slave trader captured whilst careening on the windward side of the island. I've learned 12 hard lessons from that woman, each with the same end. That sooner or later, death awaits any man who lays eyes on this place. And that before it arrives, she is determined to make you fear it.
I need the money, bro. I'm broke. I was just the middleman. I made a stupid mistake. What, so you bailing on me too?
Give me one good reason I shouldn't.
I hope you don't mind. This one's kind of personal.
No, it's fine.
I know you're my boss, and so I don't know how much I should share with you, but I feel like we've gotten closer lately, yeah?
Yeah, we have.
Okay, so there's this guy who I have feelings for, and I thought he felt the same way about me.
What do you mean, you thought?
Well, when I was away, I realized that I had these feelings. And I knew that when I came back, I had to tell him.
Sometimes guys are dense. You just have to tell them right out.
I just figured, after all the time we'd spent together, he already knew. But when I told him today, it turns out he doesn't feel the same.
Wow. I don't know what to say. I can't imagine any guy would say no to you. You're amazing.
The stench must have been incredible. The very disagreeable odors of blood. The screams of the horses going down. The screams of the men who are falling.
With a bullet in his leg, Rook is caught in the crossfire.
They're out!
What?
Damn room! I'm in the
ice. Try to get yourself to the hospital right now! You're gonna get yourself killed! Move!
Do you shop here often? I've never seen you here before.
Is this your usual approach, talking to strangers in queues?
Not really. Never actually. At least now I can say I've done it. Do you know what the word with the most consecutive vowels is?
Queuing? I saw you here yesterday.
So many people shop here.
You didn't see me?
No, I've never seen you before.